Waking up in the Hyatt was quite relaxing, and as I was here anyway, I thought I might make good use of their facilities. So I went to the gym for a morning workout to burn some calories, and to later triple gain them back with their super tasty breakfast. I even had a croissant, people. Do you know how good it is to have a croissant after months in Asia? Hyatt Raipur has been investing a lot in making their hotel more sustainable, so I wanted to know what they exactly achieved here.
Being as a, Hyatt, we have a target, like we have a worldwide initiative for 2020. There should be a reduction in your electricity consumption, there should be a reduction in your water consumption. So we are doing that and we are achieving. We have given a target of minimum 5% reduction every year in your annual consumption. So that we are achieving, and we are more focused on the, where we are wasting or where we can save.
This morning we left the hotel in Raipur. And the next place where we can stay is in a place which is 280 kilometers from here, so we're not going to make that in one day. So today, we're going for some range excitement, which means we're driving until we have 20% battery left, and then we see what happens. So today, I got a driver, personal driver, which is really good. And I've been on the road in India for some weeks now, and I know how Indians drive, so I'm very uncomfortable with Pryor driving at the moment. No kidding, he's a safe driver. And also the roads where we're on now, and also the past days are quite good actually. Like there are no holes, no bumps. So it's pretty relaxing to drive around here in India. When the battery eventually reached 20%, we stopped in this village called Saripali. We knew there was a community house, just like we found a few days ago, but it was hard to find. This village is kind of different than places we have been in the past days. It's really very, very small, very local. A lot of attention from people here when we walk out of the car. So this is the community house, or circuit house, as they actually call it. We did a walk around the house, but it seems closed. There's nobody here, and all the doors are locked. There are some kids playing here, so Prajak is now trying to get hold of them and see if they maybe know something about this place. Good?
He's calling the guy.
He's calling?
He's calling
the
guy who has the keys to this place, right?
Sorry?
He's calling the guy who apparently runs the place.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
Chowk
tak.
Chowk. Oh, aage 1.5 km.
Fir wahan se
aise bagal mein road ke bagal mein hai. Wahan puchenge kisi ko bhi puchenge tehsil office kahan hai.
Tehsil office.
So this man is the guy who manages this place, but he cannot give permission to let people stay here. So we need to go back to the some office for the government, I assume, or
basically like the tehsil, the guy who manages the district. The district officer, I guess.
Okay.
Translation.
Those problems.
Okay, what just happened? We were searching for this this place, and then a car stopped next to us. Asked if we can stop, because there was this little kid. Wanna take picture with me, selfie. So obviously I do that, and then I asked him like, can you help me out? Or do you know how to find a place to sleep? And obviously this nice man owns some hotels here in the city, and he offered us to stay there. Pretty great, or not? So now we drive, I will follow you to
Chaliana, please come. Please come with me.
A few minutes later, we arrived at Hotel Krishna, where we could plug in the car. They served us delicious local food, and we had a fun night with the owner and his friends. The next morning, we packed our bags, plugged out the car, and left Hotel Krishna to continue the road trip. Very usual sights today. Absolutely nothing special to see. Just casual nature, and definitely no crazy things happened on the road. Okay, well, just enjoy for a few seconds.
Later that day, we will arrive in Sambalpur, a middle-sized village and definitely more vivid as yesterday's. Life in India still amazes me. Today we had a host whose house matches perfectly with the color of the car.
Flash forward to the next day. I didn't shoot so much footage yesterday because we have been running all evening and all night actually to try to charge a car. It was a problematic night. Apparently the energy system here in the house was not so very strong. So we started charging at 15A, didn't work, then went to 13, to 10, to 8 and eventually even start charging at 6 ampere, which was at that time the only possibility to charge. With 6 ampere it will take maybe 3 or 4 days to fully charge a car. And it was not even sure if you could continue charging the car. So Prajak and I set alarm like every hour to check if the car was charging. And in the night I tried to go back to higher voltages, which worked. But now the car is still charging. It's 12 a.m. now. And it is now 99%. So we'll be leaving in a few minutes. But we actually wanted to leave very early today because it will be a tough day today. To the next stop is 220 kilometers, which is doable on a flat road. Today we're going into the mountains, which can also be possible if we get some generation while going down the hills, but we have no idea how it looks like. So I expect that it will be quite tough and challenging, but that's the adventure what I'm kind of nervous about today. We did already 183 kilometers today. And since the past 15-20 kilometers we've been in the mountains, which of course took a lot of energy from the car. So we now are not stuck, but we stopped in a, yeah, you cannot even call this a village. This is just two huts here and some people waiting here. And problem is we have an overheated battery. You can see here it's 46.1 degrees. And from 46 the warning signal goes off, which is not dangerous yet. It gets dangerous from like 49 degrees, then you can really damage the batteries. But the problem is also the range. We have 15% left and about 30 kilometers to go, and we're not quite sure for how far we still have to climb, because so far we haven't gone down. If we go down then it won't be a problem because we will regain a lot of electricity. These guys here, they say it's about 5 kilometers to the next village. But from my experience, it's very hard for people to give an exact estimation of the distance. Normally if they say 5 kilometers, it's usually 10 or 15. But once we get to the village, there is electricity, so then we are safe. Okay, this is the situation. We managed to get beyond the mountainous area with 10% left. We now stopped at some kind of rest stop for truckers. There is electricity here, but definitely not enough to charge a car. We have 10% left. It's 20 kilometers to the village where we need to be. We still have an overheated battery, so we've been driving with this alarm signal going on, which is terrible. I think the only solution is that we continue driving to...
We continue driving for 10 kilometers.
10 kilometers.
And he's setting us up 10 kilometers away.
Okay. So the guy where we're staying overnight, he's 20 kilometers away from here, but he knows a place 10 kilometers from here where we can might be able to charge. So that's our only hope for now. We are now in a village before the place where we actually need to go to. This is a place where our hosts send us. They know somebody here where we can charge the car for a bit, make a plan from there. Maybe we might go to their place afterwards or keep the car charging here overnight, I don't know. On Google Maps it said we need to be here, but there are just a few houses here and this doesn't seem to be the right place. So they're sending somebody now to pick us up. And it's... yeah, it's getting a strange, weird adventure. It's kind of incredible because we did 210 kilometers already, or 205 kilometers, and that with the mountains we took, That's quite a record. It's really a good achievement. So we can be proud of that.
Only if we had like excitement.
This is really only if we had like 5% more, then we were sure that we could make it to the city, which is 220 kilometers in total.
It's too much suspense. It's too much suspense.
Yeah.
Too much suspense. Like, I have a weird gut feeling that if we do, I think it can do another 11 kilometers, but like, let's not risk it.
Yeah, we have 6%. And times two, that's 12, but when it's this low,
yeah,
doubt it, I doubt it. Hello. Yeah. Are you the man?
Haan, Devakar ji, wo mil gaye aapke friend. Haan.
Aapka? Bibhuti. Bibhuti.
Bibhuti?
Bibhuti, haan.
Bibhuti?
Haan.
Ti hai ki da hai? There's a situation. So basically when they called us and said they have a place for us a little ahead, that place still had electricity. Now there's a power cut over there and they're running just the basics on their generator.
Oh shit.
Yeah, so we're fucked basically.
Okay.
And what we can do is I guess park the car over here.
Uh-huh.
And then he will take us to Kyonjar, which is our host's house.
Yeah, and but then yeah, we need to charge the car.
Haan, to ek, achha, 1 second. So, kya bol?
What?
Yeah, basically, there's no power in the entire area.
Oh.
There's no power in the entire area. This is great.
Ah, that's fun.
Yeah.
So, आगे जा करके हम बात करते हैं एक ट्रैक्टर वाला
साथ.
तो वो बोलेगा तो लेकर के आपको छोड़ देगा
क्या? Hey, no. So what he's saying is there's a guy up ahead with a tractor.
Yeah.
And he can actually tow us to Kyonjar.
You can tow us.
Yeah.
Okay.
Does that sound fun?
The plan changed a little bit. We didn't went to the tractor guy or to the place where he's supposed to charge, but the guy on the scooter, he came back and then mentioned that the power was back on. So he brought us to a place, an office of his, which was just maybe 1 kilometer from there. Trying to charge here now, but we find out that there's only 6 ampere here, and even on 6 it was not stable. So we're charging on 4 ampere, meaning, and I did a quick calculation then. It will mean that we need about 70 hours to fully charge a car, but we don't need to fully charge it here. We just need something to get to our host house. But even like this, it's going to take too long. We gave up trying to charge at this place because there's only 6 ampere available. So what we're going to do now is to try to reach the place where our hosts are. They have 15A. It's not likely that we will reach it with the 6% we have left, but the guys here have this truck, so might we not make it, then we will use this truck to tow the car to the destination. I think it's totally amazing, but we made it without recharging. 222 kilometers including mountains, and we made it with exactly 0% left. We were lucky that the road went quite down, so we went from 0 to back to 4, and then to 1, and then to 5%, and eventually we arrived at the place, at our host, with 0%.